to Rafi. Welcome, Rafi Espiritu. You're a business owner and a songwriter, and you love nature. We'll get along. We'll get along. We've also got Sarah with us. Welcome, Sarah. She's a loud native. Good for you. Okay. Here's where we're at. It's just me and you, Rafi. Welcome, if you've never been here before. We're going to give thanks. We are going to make offerings. I'm going to close the window. What's up, George? One thing I'll give thanks for is for health. What's up, Hoagie? I'm following you, Hoagie. You guys, Hoagie's devoted to a 4.5-year Venisauce watcher. What is that? An alien artist, food enthusiast. Want to know more? Always online, except at 4 a.m. What are you doing at 4 a.m.? Sleeping? Sleeping? Who's not online at 4 a.m. nowadays? Okay. So you guys, welcome everybody. Oh, Dr. Daphne's here as well. Welcome back, Dr. Daphne. You guys, Dr. Daphne is the authentic broadcaster helping women business owners discover their uniqueness and value in their industry and confidently increase profits. Man, everybody's rapping. Okay, Jesus, that's a good point. We have come to this place in time and space in order to celebrate the fact that Jesus is cannabis healing, that whole mystery, the Christos. So we do want to point that out. We also want to point out that correct prayer is in order, and that hands-on healing, as you might see in the Bible, which is contagious like diseases are, like you see in the Bible, that's also in the research. So you want to look at cannabis research, because that's tied into the anointing oil, and you want to look into the healing techniques that were done in the Bible. You want to look at that in the research like it's a thing. And then you see that victory is in the Word. Then you see that as we apply the Word and it becomes manifest, that's where we step into the kingdom. And everybody's trying to force their way. All right? Everybody's trying to make their way in. All right. And I mean, this has been the testimony for a while. We have the internet now. No longer will there be any confusion. No one's given any excuse, you know? Please tell me about anointing oil. Well, it was given to Moses in Exodus 30:23. And it's important. It's important. You see the prophets sing about it. In fact, you see Jesus' name tied up into it. They said, Yeshua, Josh. He said, who do you say that I am? He asked his favorite, and his favorite was like, oh, what's up, Yehuda? His favorite was like, oh, some say the prophet, this and that. He said, no, who do you know? Who do you know that I am? Who do you say? He says, well, I say you're the Christ, the Christos, Messiah, the Christ of God. That's his mysterious identity. What does that mean? Well, literally, Yeshua's identity is revealed to be integral, one with the anointing itself, one who's anointed in oil, one who's drenched in the anointing. Yeah? And so you check out the recipe for that, and it's got cannabis in it, cannabosum, Sula Bennett, Linguistic Science, 1936. And it hasn't changed since they put it down, because it's the tree of life, okay? So, wrap your head around that every page is drenched in oil, and then check out that cannabinoid science and see what happens miraculously when you apply a cannabinoid to a biochemical situation. See what happens there. And then see that it corroborates everything in the Word, because the science can only provide the same testimony forever and ever. And all these are for the healing of the nations and the end of every curse, you guys. Because no more confusion, there's no more night, there's no more darkness. There's only victory, which gets better and better and bigger and more awesome as each one steps into that space and wields that power. And collectively, honestly, it's a numbers game. We grow together in righteousness and power. All right, what's up, Julianne? What's up, Julianne? I see you. What's up, Vin? I'm with you guys. What's up, Trevin? Like, I'm following everybody who's here. Shelly, thanks for the hearts. They're for the healing of the nations, the end of every curse. And Vin's a magician. Cool. He comes in peace. Very good, you guys. Shelly, let me follow you. Okay, here's what I want to get to, though. Similar to the cannabinoid science, you're going to find the healing. And y'all can share this if you want, if you think this is going to help somebody in the world. Hello, Rome. Hello, Rome. What is it? Ciao. Hey, Cherry Pie, welcome. You guys, so we found out just moments ago that Jesus is weed, literally. Literally. He's the wisdom of the righteous people wielding the tree of life. He's all that in the oil, okay? Buonasera. And more, so you see how he could walk into the town and wave his hand, and if they believe, it's like the whole town just got healed, right? So these are not delusions. This is something in science, Yusuf. It's in science. This is a scientific article. It's William Bengston, Bengston, The Effects of Laying of Hands on Transplanting Human Breast Cancer Cells in Mice, Journal Scientific Exploration, year 2000. And what happens is, if you do this technique, it has a certain effect on cancer in this controlled experimental study. And what happened is, basically, if enough people thought about healthy mice and prayed correctly, I have not been to Rome. I have not yet. If enough people did the technique correctly, which anyone can learn how to do, which the apostles would have been teaching one another, teaching the people how to do. What's up, Pablo? If enough people did this, then what do you think happened? And they tested this on cancer and mice. They shot the mice up with cancer. In the control box, they're supposed to die in 30 days. In 30 days. What do you think happened if people properly considered a happy, healthy mouse, Dr. Daphne? What do you think happened in the experimental box? What do you think happened? We're gonna see what Dr. Daphne thinks happened. Usually the mice die in 30 days. Did they die quicker, slower? What happened? What happened? Am I a doctor? No, but I should be getting an honorary doctorate degree from many universities any day now. Any day they're ready. Any day they're ready. But what do you think happened? I'll tell you what happened. She's typing it right now. She's typing it. She's typing what she thinks happened. I always like to ask. I always like to ask. Okay, guys. Well, if nobody's going to take a guess, what's up, Frey 500? Yeah, I see you, Frey. I see you, buddy. I see you, Frey. Please repeat, my volume's down. Okay, so if enough people think about healthy mice in the study, and the control box is supposed to die in 30 days, what do you think happened if people did this technique? Like, could it be effective? They're thinking about healthy mice. Where do you live? I live around Oregon. What do you think happened? Did they pretty much die in 30 days? Was there like some type of placebo thing maybe out of nowhere? What happened there? It seems inside the box. Okay. Okay, I'll just tell you guys. Excuse me. Excuse me for dragging that out. But if you are hip to the cannabinoid science, this is also in the science. 100% of the mice rejected their cancer. They live normal, happy, healthy. They live their whole regular life. They rejected their cancer just because people thought about happy, healthy mice. Okay? You try to give them more cancer. You didn't need to think about them anymore. They just didn't take the cancer. They were healed for life. And the experimental box also received the healing, even though the practitioners were not thinking about, excuse me, the control box. They're supposed to shoot the control box up with cancer, put them in the closet, forget about it. But the healing is contagious if you're not resistant to it. So this is why Yeshua could walk into the town, or any good apostle, any good disciple, can walk into the town and the healing washes over everyone who receives it. Okay? If you do it right. And definitely the mission, the acts of the apostles about three things. They anointed with oil, we covered that. They healed in his name, which we're covering, and they taught everyone how to do it. These things are teachable. These things are teachable. Okay? So do you see? Do you see, pragmatically what we're talking about and how doable it is and how it's there in the word, and that word is victory. Because if the actual manifesting technique is imagining the result that you want, don't you have to know victory? Any questions, comments, concerns, thoughts? Shelley's been heart and hard. Those are all for the healing of the nations, the end of every curse, which is the end vision. The end vision at the end of the Revelation, all this, is what we're bringing out, is the healing of all the nations, and no more curse, no more darkness, no more night. Just night's a nice thing that passes by, and according to the cyclical divine order and wisdom of creation, our bodies are created to heal. That's our natural state, isn't it? I would say it's roughly 8:51. It's roughly 8:51. And the return to natural state is like the return to Eden. And like, why don't we know about this? Why isn't this our? Why aren't we living in the great city, many of us already? And really, there's no good reason, right? This is our birthright material that we're talking about. This is like something everyone should know, right? So, thank you for receiving it, because this is the most important thing anyone can really consider. So thank you for considering this. And I'll ask you, you know, to go further and consider that the apostles had urns full of cannabis oil, and they actually practiced the discipline techniques and shared these things with the people. I'm just giving you the basics, but it requires work. It requires, am I Catholic? Good question. I was raised Catholic, and a lot of Catholic art has cannabis in it. It does. But I have some problems with the fact that the Pope has not come out with urns and urns of cannabis oil and the correct prayer mechanisms in order to bring out the healing of the nations in the end of every curse. I'm a little bit questioning why the Pope isn't more on it. Are we too lazy to research and learn what's available? Are we, though? I found out. I just passed it on. I just shared it. Are we too lazy to do that? I'm not too lazy. Now, to actually do the techniques, there are some things that maybe some stumbling blocks, some obstacles for sure between us and all that, but together it's nothing, you know? Even with our mind right, these things are nothing standing in the way. There's nothing. You know, with our mind right and like knowing victory, there's nothing stopping all of us, you know? Each one can like just make his way right into heaven. I'm pretty sure like each one, if he's good and righteous, I'm pretty sure he can just make his way right on in. So even if there's one, I mean, that just breaks things open. Do you understand? Like harrowing of hell and all these things. I mean, it's ridiculous. Our nature, our natural inclination is ridiculously beautiful. And what, there's no like philosophical way to achieve redemption? Before all this, there's no way to do it? Was everyone thinking, like, wait on, that's, I guess so. Because they definitely got us pulling this thing out for practical, political applications in the world, like it's relevant. That definitely goes on. Like, maybe people should probably consider this and compare it to the science that corroborates and get on it, man. Get on it. Okay. So here's a few things we'll bring up right now, just with the few that are among us. I'm going to thank Dr. Daphne for being here, George and Mai. Me and Mai is here. And so you guys, with our collective energies right now, let's bring out the fact that everything is provided. Huh? Everything is given. And there is real peace. There is real sanctum. There's a sanctum, okay, inside of you. There is a holy place inside of each one where there's rest, gifts, love, actually understanding, knowledge, and gratitude. All these things inside of us. What do I think about the third eye? The third eye is like an aspect of human consciousness that brings in divine wisdom, okay? And, you know, you probably are going to find there's seven, There's seven lights on the candlestick there in a lot of traditions. There's seven lamps. There's seven lights, and the oil burns hot and clear in each one. Okay, so you might want to, and it's anointing oil. It's holy oil in those candlesticks, you guys. I just want to point that out. What's up, Danica? Did y'all hear me right now? The candles, the oil burning lamps, which there are seven of them, it is with anointing oil that's burning clear and bright. Drink pure water, aka distilled water, clean your pineal gland toxins. A gallon a day. I hear that's a good regimen. I hear that helps. Okay, Danica, we're just taking a moment to consider and celebrate the fact that inside of us, all these hearts are for the healing of the nations, the end of every curse. Inside of us is the power to heal all the nations and end every curse. Is we good? Ask Yeshua. Ask Yeshua. He's celebrated as a tree of life. It's kind of in his name. He's kind of all about it. Is we good? I will not let what I know to be good spoken of as evil. And I'm not going to try to make you sin about it either. We're all going to come to an understanding. What kind of water? He said distilled water. Now, I don't know about distilled water. Are you supposed to drink distilled water? Because I heard it can mess you up. What's up with that information? Is distilled water bad for you at all at a gallon a day? Tell us, tell us. Danica, I so missed you. It's so good to have you back. You guys, Mr. Mac is here. Yeah, I'm going to just ask for the share, because right now, I heard it inside of me to tune into Periscope, and here we are. And what we're talking about is the place inside. Is the place inside where there's knowing and love. Okay, now from this place, you heard alkaline. I heard all these things. You know what? I heard the water of life. There's a river of life flowing with the crystal clear water of life. Just dive in, take a gulp. It's fresh water. Distilled water is the safest water. It's pure water. Okay, distilled water. We heard, because it's distilled. Okay, here's what I want you guys to know. Jesus is weed, literally. And the Christos is like, it's not just when you anoint people with oil. It's got weed in it, but it's also got all the prayers of generations and generations and the blessing of the Almighty and all that in it, too. So it is also an energy medicine. That's why the word is put there for victory. That's why we do great miracles through him in his name, led by the Spirit, according to the wisdom of Almighty. Are y'all seeing how this works? Y'all seeing how this works right now? Okay. So no, from your space inside, you can wield all of this, and you're called to, and it is your destiny. So from your space inside, let's acknowledge that love is ever-present and growing. From your space inside, let's acknowledge that you're surrounded by true loves as well. You guys, everybody here right now, everybody in this understanding, in this reasoning, is loved by your brother. Where is anointed oil be bought? Oh, it probably should not be bought or sold. It probably should not be. Okay, here's what you can do if you want authentic anointing oil as given to Moses, which is the name, which the name of Yeshua, Jesus Christ, is. Or what his name is. If you want that recipe, okay. You're going to turn to Exodus 30:23. You're going to get yourself like 9 pounds of cannabis. And get yourself a lid of olive oil. Get yourself some fresh cinnamon. You know what I'm saying? And you're going to put that together. You're going to say the prayers. Now, a priest probably is who's supposed to put that together. But a lot of grace comes. A lot of grace comes. By the time the new covenant comes, I mean, these people aren't Jewish rabbis anointing with oil, are they? Are they? Are they Jewish rabbis? All the apostles were Jewish rabbis? No. No. That's the thing, man. They anointed with oil, they healed in his name, and they taught everybody. Okay? We're all the apostles of Christ, 12. Were they Jewish rabbis? Were the people, were the first martyrs, Stephen, was he a Jewish rabbi? Was he? Now, what I'm saying is some of these people may have been, but some of them were just probably Christian people, Gentile people, who grabbed the oil, grabbed the teaching, grabbed the truth, and beamed it out in every direction. You know what I'm saying? Ran the line in every direction. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. All right. And they were just people who knew the truth, who shared the truth. That's all it is. You tell the people. You do the things, you tell the people. That's it. You act in truth. Grace surrounds. Okay? So I just want everybody to know this message is for you. I just want everybody to know this this mission, this way, this plight, this solution is for you. Okay, I want you to know it's for you. I want you to know it's for you, Eric Johns. I want you to know this message is yours to own. Tony, this one's yours. This one's for you to deal with. Because, listen, you're giving your energy to all this stuff, right? We're giving our energy to a lot of stuff. Let's just give it, let's just put it where it naturally should be. Just put it where it naturally should be. Which is in our good power, in our good power. You know, I am making an offering because we're getting into the truth of the matter. And the truth is, the tent of meeting had a cloud above it. And the anointing oil has cannabosum in it. And there's no way out of the linguistic, archaeological, historical, scriptural evidences, which lead to no other reasonable, logical, accurate conclusion than what the tree of life is. And the gospel of Christ, to those who are dead, is the stench of death. But to the living, it's a sweet aroma of knowledge of God. My battery's going out. Peace and blessings in Yeshua the Christos.